guys, how's it going? I wanted to bring you the updated Marlin XT rifle. In my previous video, I said I was going to be doing some upgrades, and this here is it all finished up. I went ahead and had the whole rifle dipped in a Multicam pattern, and I'm really impressed with how it turned out. I sent it off to be dipped professionally, and there's a few minor flaws in it, but for overall, I think it turned out really good. You might be able to pick them up on the camera, but I doubt it. Give you a good look at that. It just looks sick. Just awesome. I went ahead and added a extended bolt knob there. I got that on eBay for about 20 bucks. I did have to TIG weld a threaded portion of a bolt onto the rod here, and then just went ahead and threaded that on with some red Loctite, and it's really nice and secure. It adds just a little bit to the rifle. A little bit of leverage. That was one of my big complaints about the Marlin rifle, is that it just had this tiny little knob on there, and I didn't like it. It felt small, and it just didn't work very good. I mean, it worked good, but I wanted something a little bit bigger, and this works out really well. That was about a $20 modification, and I'm really happy with how it turned out. It doesn't stick out very far, just enough to get you some extra leverage, so really happy with that. I did go ahead and put on a different scope. The scope I had on there before was a decent scope, but this one absolutely blows it out of the water. This is a Vortex Diamondback HP. This is the 3-12 model with a side parallax adjustment, as you can see there. This is a fantastic scope. I got this one also on eBay for a smoking deal. If I was going to go ahead and make any kind of modification to this scope, it would only be a 30mm tube. Other than that, this is just outstanding. Really happy with the scope. If I was going to pay to have a scope dipped, I wanted to make sure it was a good scope and that one that was going to last for quite a while. Hopefully the life of the rifle. So I went ahead and picked up the Vortex. The other scope was decent, but I didn't want to pay to have a cheap scope dipped, and I wanted to go ahead and go with something quality. And I've had quite a few Vortex scopes in the past, so I feel pretty confident about their quality. All in all, I'm just super happy with how this project turned out, and I'm having a lot of fun shooting it. When I can find the 22 ammo, of course, it's still scarce to come by. But I'm loving this rifle. It's probably one of my favorite ones right now. So I just wanted to give you guys a quick look at it, and hopefully some more shooting footage, more to come. So thanks a lot, guys, for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.